Live from inside a giant Atari symbol, it's the first annual Emmys!
Good evening, and welcome to the Golden Particles. I guess no one told the announcer, we were originally going to be called the Emmys after German mathematician Emmy Noether. Her equations are all throughout particle physics, but we found out at the last minute that the Emmys was taken, so we had to rebrand. Apologize if anyone was confused or disappointed when they got here. But welcome to the Golden Particles. I am your host, Teeny Turner, and tonight we're here to honor the achievements by particles, experiments, and ideas in physics over the past year. And let me tell you, I'm a bit overwhelmed. There are some megawatt A-list stars here in the room. Gravity is here. I loved you in George Clooney. Gravity directed the formation of galaxy clusters early in the universe's history, though you probably know it best for that time it threw you down a flight of stairs. Dark energy is also here tonight. Welcome. Dark energy makes up 70% of all the matter and energy in the universe. The other 30%, as we all know, is 5-hour energy. No, dark energy is a mysterious force that is accelerating the expansion of our universe. Scientists say they don't know what's causing it, but I think most everyone watching probably has a good idea about what causes accelerating expansion. It's donuts. We've all been there. Quantum computers are here. No one really knows what that means, but everyone seems very excited about it. Quantum computers take advantage of weird phenomena that happen at the smallest scales, and could have applications in everything from cryptography to biology. And, you know, most importantly, quantum TikToks. I'm looking forward to both watching them and not watching them simultaneously. The CMS detector is joining us remotely from CERN. Researchers have been working on an upgrade to the timing mechanism that would allow the detector to take 30 billion pictures per second. Unfortunately, the Higgs boson still insists on making duck face in all of them. Stop it. The axion is also here, my friends. The axion is nominated as a dark matter candidate alongside the WIMP and the dark photon. Most people don't know that until a few years ago, the axion was going by the name of Axe and working full-time as a body spray. Just goes to show, never give up on your dreams. Finally, tonight, we are also honoring the proton with the Cecil B. DeYoung Mills Lifetime Achievement Award. No one has ever seen a proton decay, so presumably it's had a lot of time to get things accomplished. Before we get going, I want to take a moment to thank our hosts for the evening, the HFPA. Yes, that's the HEP Fundamental Particle Association, and the HEP stands for High Energy Physics. HFPA is brought to us by nested science acronyms, because if it's not nested, it's not confusing. Now, on to the awards. Particle physics sits at the extremes. Researchers study the smallest building blocks of nature using the biggest detectors and the most powerful accelerators to make the most precise measurements. Our first award honors the ingenuity of particles that work so hard to remain hidden. The nominees for hardest particle to detect are neutrinos for their role in too fast, too furious to interact. The story of antisocial particles that refuse to interact through either the strong force or electromagnetism. Dark matter in Catch Me If You Can. Despite leaving hints of its existence across the galaxy, no one has successfully determined what dark matter is. Supersymmetric particles in Desperately Seeking SUSY. The tale of the search for proposed particles that would explain the mass of the Higgs boson. And the award goes to Dark Matter. Dark Matter is accepting the award remotely. Let's go live to Dark Matter now. Unfortunately, it appears we have some technical issues. We have a bad connection to dark matter, but we do offer our warmest congratulations. We'll be right back with more awards from the Golden Particles after this message. Are you a national lab with a herd of picky bison? Yeah, me too. That's why I feed my furry friends fermions. Fermions combine the delicious flavors of leptons with the nutritional building blocks of quarks. It's a healthy treat they'll love, and I'll feel good knowing it's 100% gluon-free. Fermions, from the makers of positrons. Progress in particle physics is the result of hard work by dedicated individuals. And it is painstaking work, checking and rechecking, simulations and analyses. It's often incremental and rarely glamorous. It's not the kind of thing that can be captured in a single image. Our next award keeps that front of mind. The nominees for shiniest costume design are Mu-E in The Transporter Solenoid. This experiment will look for the direct conversion of a muon into an electron. Rigorous testing of the magnets that will form the experiment's transport solenoid was completed in 2020. The Deep Underground Neutrino Experiment, ProtoDUNE Detector, in Some Like It Cold. ProtoDUNE is a testbed the size of a three-story house designed to assess technologies for the even bigger detectors planned for DUNE. The detector is filled with liquid argon and operated at minus 300 degrees Fahrenheit. PIP-II accelerator cavities in Jurassic Particles. Upgrades to the Fermilab accelerator complex will include a new linear accelerator made of several kinds of cavities. It will accelerate particles close to the speed of light and power many of Fermilab's experiments. And the award goes to the Deep Underground Neutrino Experiment, ProtoDUNE. DUNE couldn't be here tonight as the experiment is currently moving 800,000 tons of rock from a mile underground to make space for the full-size particle detectors. But it's a good segue because the machines used for particle physics research are truly extraordinary. I mean, without them, we would just be staring really intently into space and not making a whole lot of progress. The nominees this year also remind us that the timescale for physics is very long, and that old dogs can learn new tricks. The nominees for Best Supporting Equipment are the DZero experiment in You've Got Data. In this heartwarming tale, the DZero experiment at Fermilab produced mountains of data before retiring in 2011. A decade later, it combined with an experiment at CERN to discover the Adleron, a particle that researchers had been looking for 50 years. ICARUS in Ghost Particle Busters. The ICARUS detector studied hard-to-catch neutrinos in Italy until 2014. It was then refurbished and shipped overseas to Fermilab. It will begin attempts to track and capture a fourth kind of neutrino called the sterile neutrino later this year. The Muon G-2 magnet in Return of the Ring. This epic fantasy was 20 years in the making. The superconducting storage ring found hints of an anomaly in an experiment at Brookhaven National Lab in 2001. The magnet was moved to Fermilab so the experiment could be upgraded and repeated. Researchers confirmed the anomaly earlier this month. And the award goes to Muon G-2 magnet.
Oh my gosh! This is amazing. I can't believe it. First off, I have to thank all of the muons that circulated inside me. I wanted them to come up on stage with me, but they decayed after 2 millionths of a second. Everyone, DOE, HFPA, MC1, Brookhaven, the transport team. I should have written a list. I'm so sorry if I'm forgetting you, but you know who you are, and I thank you. The team that shimmed my magnetic field until it was insanely uniform. You're amazing. The laser calibration system, the simulations, the analysis team. Oh, I'm out of time, but there are so many other people, the international partners, everyone. Thank you so much for this incredible honor.
Terrific. Our next award is for Most Confusing Equation. I'm being told that we are out of time. We'll publish the rest of the award winners in a reputable journal. Thank you for tuning in, and join us next year for the second annual Golden Particles.